already the hottest import. A personal appearance by the Beatles in America caused such hysteria and fascination, it was as if they had arrived from another planet. The editor of Rolling Stone magazine remembers they were fresh, bright, charming, optimistic, and sweet.
I just want you to know that we appreciate what the people of Britain have done for us.
To their fans and the press, the Beatles were just as entertaining offstage as they were playing their music. What made the Beatles different were their numerous fans. Hordes of adoring young women screaming and fainting at just the mention of John, Paul, George, or Ringo. The fans' excited and dramatic reaction was a signal to the rest of the community that a powerful source had just been unleashed, and the press was quick to track them down. Of course, this success was skillfully planned by their manager, Brian Epstein.
Do you enjoy the ride?
Oh, well, please. Standing there in your new coat.
Seeing as they got so, you know, they didn't mind.
We'd like to pay a tribute for you, coming on the open cut. In that truck round, because the kids have been waiting all night, and they appreciate it.
Well, they deserved it, didn't they, waiting all night?
Yeah. I hope you're wearing rip-dry clothes, were you?
No, we just thought it was going to be sunny.
George, who selected the name The Beatles, and how did you derive this particular name? With
well,
the BEA instead
John
of
got the name Beatles
in a video,
ages ago, you know, when we wanted, when we needed a name, and everybody's thinking of a name, and he thought of Beatles.
Why the BEA instead of the BEA?
Well, no, actually, you know,
Well, unless it was
B-double-E,
it was hard enough getting people to understand why it was
B-E-A,
never mind.
Do you have any acknowledged leader of the group?
No, not really. John, has the Mersey beat changed since you've been playing it?
Oh, we still keep on then. There's no such thing as Mersey. It's something the press made up.
Well, what do you play the same way now as you did?
It's rock and roll, just so happens we write most of it.
It's Buddy Holly influenced your music at all, Joe?
He did in the early days, obviously, you know. But, no, well, not obviously, but you know, he's one of the greats. And that,
so did James Thurber, though, didn't he?
Oh, yeah, but he doesn't sing for it.
You play the kind of music you want to play, or the kind of music you think people want to hear?
No, we've been playing this kind of music 5 or 6 years, or something like that. It's just rock and roll, you know, it just happened to be right.
Well, what do you think made the difference that suddenly pushed you up above the other groups?
We got a record contract.
Before their debut in America, a barrage of publicity had been distributed and the Beatles got a gig on the Ed Sullivan Show.
Hi, Ed. Is he on? He's watching in this one. Look, there he is. Oh, hi, Ed. It's Mrs. Ed.
Oh, I'm Mr. Ed.
After the Beatles' first appearance on the Ed Sullivan Show, every girl had chosen her favorite, and that's all she talked about. The reaction of these young females was sweeping, because there were millions of them. Baby boomers born in the 3 years following World War II, their birth had been an anecdote to war. And now, they were singing the praises of love and life. In both countries, the Beatles found huge audiences. And they weren't just limited to females. Young men loved the Beatles just as much. While their girlfriends wildly screamed the name of their favorite Beatle, most young men were not threatened. Authors and historians all have their own reasons why men identified with the Beatles. Some say they saw the musicians as a male-bonded group, something the young men in urban areas can relate to. Working-class men in Glasgow and Liverpool often formed groups to fight over territories, but others point out the Beatles' music was more about camaraderie than conquest. We saw them as a group of individuals whose personalities were played out in their music, and we wanted to learn more about each one of them.
Ladies and gentlemen, they'll be up in a few moments. They are getting themselves ready, and let me tell you, they told customers they can't wait to make this their greatest appearance. What do you think of these fabulous Beatles? Let's hear it for them. Let them hear it in the dressing room.